Hey everyone, I'm Yann Braga, Storybook Maintainer at Chromatic, and I'm here to talk about exciting new integrations for Storybook with Vite and Vitest. But before, for the ones that don't know, Storybook is the most popular tool for building UI components in isolation to assist engineers with development, testing, and documentation. Let me show it in practice. On the left side, I have a button component. It has different UI based on props like large, clear, and round. So similar to how you write tests in a co-located test file in the component directory, for Storybook, you have a stories file. This is where you define which component you want to render, you can provide properties to be applied, and then each one of your named exports translates to a UI state, which we call a story. You can also refer these stories in an MDX file, which would attach custom documentation to that component. So let's start Storybook to see how it looks like. As I run Yarn Storybook, it uses Vite to serve all the code, which is super fast. It opens the browser and the first story is for my button component. You can see that that documentation is coming from the MDX file I have over here. So you can even attach live Figma design specs, which I find pretty cool. But anyways, let's go back to our stories file and we see that the default and clear story relates to the ones on the sidebar. So I can easily see the different variants of my components and I can use the controls add-on to tweak with its props. For instance, making the button round. And let's change the text to like, hello ViteConf. And now I can click on the save button, which will actually save the code right there for me. It's also quite handy to create new stories. Let's create a disable button state. So we toggle the prop and then we can click on the new button. We give it a name. And as you can see, now I have a disabled state in my story file. You can see how easy it is to cover all UI states of your components, right? Stories are essentially tests. Apart from passing props to them, you can also write interactions and assertions by using the stories play function. You can use test utilities to, for instance, locate the button and then expect it to be disabled. The expect function comes from the Storybook test package, which is powered by Vitest, by the way. As I save the file, the test will run and on the right side, there's an interactions panel, which will show all of the steps related to the test we just wrote in the play function. So let's cause a regression by changing the disabled property to false. And on the right side, we see a failure mentioning that the button is not disabled. Once we fix the failure and save, it's all green, it's all good. You can use Storybook to develop all sorts of components from simple to complex. Like I have many stories, for instance, pretty much for all of my components in the project. So with advanced mocking mechanisms, I can use Storybook to even render fully fledged pages. Like for instance, this restaurant detail page. I can use the play function with interactions to, for instance, open a model, or I can mock network requests, allowing me to easily access hard to reach states like a loading, not found, and error states. So how does Storybook relate to Vite? Storybook is built on top of Vite and integrates tightly with the Vite ecosystem. This is the third year in a row that we're sharing about Storybook at ViteConf, and each year the connection gets deeper and better. Before we talk about a brand new integration to Storybook, I would like to share a couple of updates on Storybook 8, our latest version. First, I'm excited to report that a whopping 65% of new Storybooks are using Vite. This is more about Vite's success than Storybook, but it's really exciting for us because the developer experience of Vite is just amazing. Also, in Storybook 8, we consolidated many Storybook packages, which resulted in a drastic install size reduction from previous versions up to 50% smaller. We're also working together with the E18E, the incredible ecosystem performance community, getting continuous contributions like replacement of older packages with newer ones, as well as many optimizations which are making Storybook smaller and faster. We are partnering with the Vite and Vitest teams to make Storybook even better. Storybook is now part of the Vite ecosystem CI, making sure that Vite and Storybook are always compatible with every new release. Now I'm excited for our biggest update, which is component testing with Storybook and Vitest. This is a deep collaboration between the Storybook and the Vitest team. And before I get into the details, I would like to give a huge shout out to Vladimir and the Vitest team, who have been amazing to work with. Now let's talk about component testing. In this project, I am using Vitest alongside a few test files. I'm basically testing some React hooks using testing library. I'm also using the amazing Vitest VS Code extension, which detects all my test files and shows them directly in the extension sidebar where you can execute them without using the CLI, which is super handy. So let's go to the testing tab. And then right here, you can see all of my tests. I can click on this button to jump into the test definition. I can also run specific tests by clicking on this play button. And I can run tests from a specific file, or I can run all tests from a particular directory, which is super cool and convenient. I can also run all of the tests in coverage mode, and then I can see the coverage information at the bottom. I can also go to the Explorer sidebar and look into the coverage per file over here. I can see that my hooks files, they have about 74 and 100% code coverage. However, my entire application has only 2%, which is really bad. But that's not true. Stories are tests, and in this project, I have tons of stories which test and cover a lot of my code. The thing is that the story tests are not automated or integrated with my Vitest suite. Well, not anymore. We now provide a new experimental Vitest plugin that fully integrates your stories in your Vitest configuration, all of which can be configured by running a single command, npx storybook add experimental add-on test. This command will install the Storybook add-on, which is compatible with React, Svelte, and Vue. It will install and set up the Vitest browser mode with Playwright so you can run your tests in a real browser environment. Finally, it will add the necessary Vitest configuration files for your project. And that's it. The installation assistant tells me that I can run npx Vitest project storybook to run all of my story tests, or that I can use the Vitest extension in the editor to look at all my tests. So let's open the workspace file to see how things actually work. So the command configured a Vitest workspace file that integrates with my existing testing suite, and then it adds a new one for my stories using Vitest browser mode with Playwright for high fidelity tests. So the core functionality actually comes from the Storybook Vitest plugin, which transforms all of your stories into Vitest tests. You don't even need Storybook to be running in order to test your stories, but you can always pass a Storybook script option to the plugin so that when you run Vitest, it runs Storybook in background in case you want to inspect your stories upon failure. Now that it's all set up, let's revisit the test tab. Not only do we have the tests from our original testing suite, but we now have tons more tests coming from the story files. For instance, in the components section, we have the button stories that we worked on before. We can go into the file, and now all of the stories are seen as tests by Vitest. As I click on this button, it spawns a Chromium browser and runs the tests in Vitest browser mode. I can test all of my button stories by clicking on this button, and if there's a failure, for instance, let's force one, when I rerun the tests, I get an inline error message directly in the file, which is incredibly cool. I don't even need to leave the file to understand what's going on. In this case, the error message is quite clear, right? The button is not disabled when it should be. But you can imagine that most of the times the error messages are quite cryptic, and therefore you need something more visual to inspect and understand what's going on. Because we provide a Storybook script to the plugin, the Vitest plugin ran Storybook in the background and provided a URL which will make debugging just a breeze. So once we click on the URL, it brings us to the failing story with the interaction spindle open so we can see what's happening. Then I can go back into VS Code and then fix the regression so that I can rerun my tests. And it's all passing in Vitest as well as in Storybook. This click to debug functionality is especially useful if you publish your Storybook as part of CI. And if the tests fail, you can actually point to that live Storybook where you can jump to the failure directly from CI. Now let me show you a more complete testing example so you can see how cool it is to debug things in Storybook. Let's go from this simple button to the stories for my entire application. So in this story, I essentially visit the homepage of my app, where I can actually navigate through it manually myself, and then I can see how my app behaves in different flows. I can click on the remount button to bring it back to its initial state. However, I have stories where I automate all of these actions by writing interactions and assertions in the play function, allowing me to test the app basically from end to end. And the cool thing here is that every step in the play function is shown in the interactions panel, and I can use the debugger to step through them. I can go back and forth. I can even jump onto like a specific step, and then I can see how my component looks at every step of the way. If there was a failure in the tests, we would easily know what happened, where it happened, and how the component looked like at that moment. And all of this works the same in a deployed storybook, by the way. This means that from a single URL, all of your teammates could see and debug the failures without even having Storybook in their machines. As you can see, not only I have stories for my button components, but also for pretty much all of the components, testing many different use cases in multiple stories. So my code coverage should actually be much, much higher than 2%. Let's go back into VS Code and rerun all my tests with coverage again. This runs all of my non-Storybook tests in Node, as well as my Storybook tests in a real browser with Playwright. For the stories that don't have a play function, they're smoke tested and will fail if the rendering doesn't succeed. Once I get the test results back, I see a lot more coverage. So if I go back into my sidebar, things are much more exciting. I went from 2% to a whopping 86% of code coverage by using Storybook. So you can now use the power of Storybook while developing and get automated Vitest tests for free. And that was component testing with Storybook and Vitest. You can turn all of your stories into tests, you can increase your code coverage greatly with all of your stories, you integrate with existing testing suite, so you can extend and run alongside of your existing tests, and of course, use Vitest browser mode for fast and reliable tests. Now, you might be wondering, well, what if I'm using Storybook for Next.js, which is a Webpack-based framework? Will I be able to use this new integration? Yes, actually, we're also happy to announce a new Storybook package for Next.js and Vite. So the Storybook experimental Next.js Vite package not only allows you to use the new Vitest integration in Storybook, but also to run Storybook for Next.js with Vite as a builder. So that means that you get all of the speed from Vite, but also the features from Next.js, such as the image component, navigation, React server components, and much more. And all these things are available today in Storybook 8.3. So please try it out. We're really looking forward to your feedback. Now let's take a look into the future, shall we? What's coming in Storybook 9? Vitest is the backbone of our component testing efforts, but functional tests are not the only kinds of tests we're interested in. Storybook also has best-in-class visual and accessibility tests, and we're looking to bring this into a unified UI in Storybook sidebar. Powered by Vitest, running automated tests on the click of a button, toggling watch mode whenever you want, being able to choose different types of tests. You can also filter the sidebar based on story statuses so you can glance at the stories which are failing or have any warnings. Vite has been really great for dragging the JS ecosystem towards ESM, and Storybook is looking to join that fight and are hoping to ship an ESM-only release in Storybook 9. This will also bring a lot of reduction on our install size, and we have much more in store to make Storybook even smaller. And that was it. I'm Yann Braga. Thank you so much for your time and joining me at ViteConf, and I'll see you next time.